If you caught the daily new case numbers for where you live today, you might have noticed that compared to recent days, New South Wales,
30,062 cases,
seems strangely low. Queensland's,
18,000 new cases,
seems really high. And Victoria,
44,155,
has gone from reporting less than half of New South Wales's daily numbers to 50% more. Even after ruling 7,000 Christmas and New Year PCR swabs as too old to bother with. The topsy-turvy numbers are at least in part because residents in Victoria and Queensland can now report their rapid test results online.
This is fantastic to get so many already entering their data into our system since midday yesterday.
A service New South Wales still doesn't have up and running.
From mid this week, the advice I've received from New South Wales Health is that you will be able to register that positive rapid antigen test through your service New South Wales app.
With rapid tests still extremely hard for most people to find or afford, experts suspect that even those numbers will be way off.
We don't know what proportion of people with COVID are still giving their rapid antigen tests or are even doing them.
Victoria, Queensland and New South Wales today stress that tracking the spread isn't the only priority.
It's not simply for the purpose of registering case numbers, it's for the purpose of connecting those people with underlying conditions with care.
While the true amount of COVID in the community is a mystery, the country's Deputy Chief Medical Officer is warning lots of COVID will create lots more.
It's likely that many of us will test positive for COVID-19 over coming days and weeks.
His hot tip?
My advice is that you make sure you have some paracetamol or ibuprofen at home. It's important to be prepared because you won't be able to go to your supermarket or pharmacy if you are diagnosed with COVID-19.
Well, for his thoughts on rapid tests, the numbers and Panadol, we're catching up with epidemiologist Tony Blakely. So, Tony, what do you make of Australia's transition to rapid testing?
Well, initially, it was a policy debacle. We knew for 6 months it was coming up. Why we didn't have more rapid antigen tests, I don't know. But as far as the transition, given that bad start, I think we've done pretty well. So getting the systems over to a rapid antigen test, places like Victoria now having systems where you can upload your rapid antigen test, that's going pretty well. The stocks need to come through to support that, though, at the moment, and that's where our weakness is. We just don't have enough stock in the country for perhaps another 10 days.
So if the focus is now on getting help to those who need it, and rapid testing is filling the role that PCR testing previously filled, does it ultimately matter if we know what the total numbers are?
Yes and no. It's a tricky answer. We are now focused on the hospitalisations. But you don't know the hospitalisation number until 2 weeks after the infection peak. So you still want to know what the infection peak is, and we've lost that ability. However, we can learn from what's happened in New South Wales and now Victoria and know that this thing's explosive. And the lesson, whether or not you had that data, is the same. Slow it down. Get the masks on. Get people working at home. Put some density limits. Just slow this thing down so that the health services can manage us. So we can still manage our way through it without the numbers. It's a bit unfortunate to not have those numbers, though, to give an accurate projection of what the hospitalisations will be. We've lost that ability a bit now.
Tony, we've been told that you yourself are in isolation right now. Have you done a rapid test?
I knew it. He's off his shirt.
Yes,
normally there's this fantastic shirt. That explains everything.
He doesn't have
everything.
His options, Hamish. Yeah. He doesn't have all his options.
Yeah. I did a rapid antigen test yesterday. It was negative. My partner, she did one today, positive, and her sister, positive. But the interesting thing here is that I've had quite bad gastro. I won't go into details.
Thank
for the
you.
Last week, and I thought it was initially from contamination stuff in our esky over the Christmas period. But in retrospect, I think I'm one of those people who's had a gastro type of COVID without the upper respiratory infection symptoms, which means I won't test positive for rapid antigen test. Even a PCR for somebody like me would have had a less than half chance of picking up my illness, which kind of makes sense. Well, just shows you how sneaky this virus is.
Tony, I hesitate to ask this, but how do we test if it is a gastro issue?
We're not going there.
OK, well, we'll change the subject now. Queensland confirmed today that it's going ahead and delaying the start of school by 2 weeks. Do you think that's the best move?
I think it's quite wise. And the reason being is Queensland, say, another week or 2 weeks perhaps behind Victoria, New South Wales. And so they may have peaked by the time the kids go back or just be peaking. And seeing the kids back then could just keep that peak longer and stress out the health services. So I think it makes sense. The question then is, does it make sense for New South Wales and Victoria? Possibly not, because we hope we'll be past the peak of the infections by the time the kids get back. But there's a complex decision here, because if we as society really don't want to impose much more risk on kids, you'd keep them back from school. But at the same time, you want them to go to school for educational, social reasons, allowing the parents to go back to work. It's quite a complicated decision. But I think from Queensland's perspective, and maybe South Australia and Tasmania, that's something they may want to consider, because the peak is going to be pretty close to when the kids go back.
Tony, did paracetamol, ibuprofen, and after what you've described, gastrostop, just become the new must-have for panic buyers?
Yeah, you want some Panadol. I've been using a fair bit of it myself personally, and ibuprofen. Get the stuff in place. I've learned a few more things in the last 24 hours, so just a basic, proper disinfectant, not the one just for bacteria, but the ones for viruses, something with ammonium or hypochlorite, and that we're looking for at the moment so we can clean the kitchen so my stepson can come down and we haven't contaminated the surfaces. So that's something I would add to it. And of course, the obvious one is it would be great to have 10 rapid antigen tests in this household now, because we can't go out and get them. So other people are going to get them for us, and that's quite complicated at the moment. Those would be my extra suggestions.
Yep, that's yet another link in the chain that's missing. But Tony Blakely, we hope you and your tummy survived the night. Appreciate your time.
Pleasure. Hope that was useful.